Let's check the FET settings. A quick view of the settings is interesting for the newcomer already from the beginning. Search for updates on startup is a nice feature. Enable it, and FET will always point out to newer versions on startup. Change the language to your preferred one. I recommend to create two folders. The folder with your FET files and the folder with the FET results. Set up the FET results folder by the option Select Output Directory in the settings. The results will be written into that folder as soon as you generate a timetable. There will be a folder with the generated file name. Maybe you wonder why it generates so fast this time. It's because I am generating an already solved dataset from the results folder. Let's have a look at all that files. Most of them are HTML files and they will be opened by your web browser as soon as you click on them. You can check them all separately, but it might be easier if you open the index. This will give you a tidy overview about most files in this folder. The soft conflicts list will show broken constraints if you use weights with less than 100%. The students and teachers statistics give you information about the generated timetable. Check these statistics after you generated the timetable. It will help you to find bugs. There are three XML files. Most users don't need them. You will also see a lot of different timetables. Just click on them and check how they look like. They are only different in design. Days horizontal tables displays the days from left to right, or opposite if you use a right to left language. Days vertical displays the days from up to down. Time horizontal displays the days and hours from left to right. Time vertical displays the days and hours from up to down. The students' timetables are available in three variants: years, groups and subgroup timetables. Especially the subgroups' timetables might be very large. Take some time and check the tables. You might notice that you won't need all of them. So it might be recommended to disable some of them. You will save disk space and the folder won't look too crowded. I myself don't need the XML files, time horizontal and time vertical. So I disable them. Since I don't print individual timetables for each single student, I also don't need the subgroups timetables. My school is pretty large. So the all activities tables won't help me. Now let's generate again and view the results. Check the dates in the results folder. The new files overwrote the old files without a warning. I already prepared the next examples. You need to generate the timetable again if you want to reproduce it. Another interesting setting is the HTML level of generated timetables. Many users will only need level 2. If you design the timetables yourself with CSS, you might need a higher level. There are two other nice levels. Level 5, add a small JavaScript program into the HTML files. If you generate that timetables, you will have a nice feature. As soon as the mouse is over a name, all similar names will be highlighted. This might help you to read the timetable. If you need a similar feature on paper, you might choose HTML level 7. Now the tables are pretty colorful, some guys like that but other guys hate it. Decide for yourself. Print detailed timetables means that there might be printed more than just one activity into a single time slot. All slots with more than one activity will be replaced by 3 question marks if you disable this feature. So in normal case this feature should stay enabled. The teacher's free timetables contain very much information. You can use this table if you need substitution for other teachers. Normally less information is still fine. So I disabled this feature. By this, not available teachers, teachers with free days and teachers that need to stay much longer or need to come much early won't be printed. The print activity tags is needed by the timetable maker. He can find bugs easier if he can see the tags. The other teachers normally never need to see the tags, the timetables become too large and teachers and students are confused. So I have it enabled, as long as I work with the dataset, but I disable it as soon as I publish the timetable. You can mark not available times and breaks. Keep it enabled as long as you work with FET, since it helps you to understand bugs. Maybe disable it as soon as you want to publish the final result. Divide the HTML timetables with time axis per day is a nice feature if you print large tables. You will notice that printing those tables don't fit on a single page if you print that tables. The trick is to split those tables. I will explain it more detailed in another video. Duplicating names on the right might help reading the tables if you have got large tables. But don't forget the small disadvantage, the timetables grow a bit and might not fit on a single page. I recommend to print activities with same starting times at least as long as you are working with the dataset as the timetable maker. Of course, this feature will print activities with same starting time into the same slot. You can still disable this later if you don't want to publish the timetable that way. Let's check the settings of the interface. You can use colors in the interface. Same as with the HTML timetables, some guys like automatic colors and others don't. Give colors a try and enable them. You can still disable them later if you don't like it. Also, the tooltips are not bad. Enable them. There are two show subgroups settings. Both are enabled by default since we don't know how you use FET. But most schools don't need them. Or, that subgroups are wasting space in the interface. They are only internally needed, but not by the user, especially if you use the automatically divide year by categories feature when you set up the students. So I disable them. There are also a few confirmation settings. Keep them enabled at the beginning. You can still disable them later if they bother you. The advanced settings are only for highly advanced users. Please don't touch this settings if you just start timetabling with FET the first time. Settings should be fine now. In the worst case, you can restore the default settings.